All right. Well, we had some technical difficulties in the previous run. The audio cut out of the last episode, which covered a couple of days, a couple of really good days too, which is too bad. Just some solid ground attack work. And not just on my part, but also on the part of some of my wingmen, like Kyle Gonzalez, I believe is his name. My good friend, my fellow flight officer. Let me see if this fellow. He did some good work. So let's just quick look at the stats here. So yeah, I've obviously been doing all right. Five planes isn't too bad. Two of them were parked, so you know, nothing really to write home about. But lots of trucks, armored vehicles, and a few other things, including some buildings. So I mean, we had a good couple of days, and like I say, Kyle even is knocking some things out, which I mean, great for him. Great for him. I hope to see both of us continue to survive and do well. And nothing too devastating to this squadron in the last couple of days. But yep, that's all gone. It's a wash. The audio is missing all of the in-game audio, and then even my spoken audio is all kind of crackly. So hopefully it's doing better today. Sometimes that happens when I just start things out of order. There's a certain launch sequence that things like, I guess, so. So, next up here for the day's mission, I think I'm just on this one that's the enemy railway junction attack. Expect that to be somewhat dangerous and also quite long. It's a long way to fly. Part of me is like, why couldn't the Spitz and the Tempests up here have done something about that? But here we are as the most forward American base. We've gotta carry some of that responsibility ourselves, so that's fine. We'll do what we've gotta do, but it will be a little bit of a longer flight. But at least not terribly deep over enemy lines. So if things turn south, I can basically just egress west and try to get into this area. Even could probably ditch at one of these or near one of these bases if I really had to. So. That's what we're looking at. Nothing too terrible. Let's real quick review the flight roster. Really no names I recognize in here, if I'm being honest. This squadron's so big, it's hard to keep track of all the folks. I basically keep track of Kyle, and that's kind of it. So. It's a bit windy, and not terribly cold, but cool, sure. And very, very high cloud deck, which has just kind of been pretty standard so far in this career. It is October 12th. We did have suspended operations for a couple of days. You can see that's what these three marked days are for. Basically, they gave us kind of a weekend, which is nice. I think that pretty well gets us up to speed. So let's get the show on the road. It would be interesting to know what aircraft are at those German airfields nearby. There's three of them there, obviously real close to the area that we're going to be flying. Be interesting to know, are they 109s or 190s, or are they mostly ground attack? Because we really haven't been running into much, I'll say, opposition. Not much at all. my bad. I was just checking a thing. Let's see, it'll probably start us up about by this first waypoint, which isn't bad. And we follow the line all the way up. This is a long way. I mean, I know how long it takes just to fly over here, so this isn't a short distance. Up by that river. But I can only assume that it's that it'll be well worth the while we can pull it off, so make sure there's no good mods available. Okay, nope. Alright. Well, let's just go then.
Beyond that yet.
that's the Coast River, so maybe that is the main. Okay. It's still a long way, but at least it's a manageable distance.
off, man. Patrol for ground targets on your own.
There we go.
Out.
Time to look for a train. That's the city in question. Where it's going. That might be the train on the far northern side. So it's either that or it goes right to the factory. Either way, an ideal scenario, I would turn and run along the track. So I think I'm seeing the track now. Oh, and I'm seeing the train. Alright. Let's see what I can do. Do it. So the enemy fighters don't have time to come in and support. That guy's still carrying all of his bombs. seems like it flies a little bit sideways. Can't seem to fly it straight. It just perpetually drifts. I'm not going to try and fly with these guys. I can beat them home, so that's what I'm going to do. Get up a little bit more. Let's put the cloud deck in. stuff.
Close to zero. I'm also beginning to gain speed, which is
chill up here, you know? Pushing down on my stick against the lift from the speed. Yeah, and this flight is over, man. Wow. Yeah, that speed. Eyes on the airfield. Coming in hot. I don't know if I'll be able to slow down enough to go straight in, but we'll try. 400 miles an hour to bleed off on 300 or so. Don't want to land by the books. Still doing about 400. Definitely got some lower air turbines. They're so smooth up high. Alright, let's come back and let that energy just breathe. I've got plenty of it. I don't see how I could possibly slow down soon enough to make this a first pass landing. Also, I'm drifting to the left again, I see. sideways as usual, I guess. Mind if the wind died down a bit in these maps. Three vehicles, four railroads, one building. Not bad at all. And everybody should make it home just fine here. See if anybody else blew anything up. I think they did. I think they had some good rocket hits, maybe some good bombs. The train was actually hit by the time I got there. Let's have a look. Good old Jeremy White. He got a couple things done. He was the only one, but better than nothing. All right, let's let Kyle's flight go. Let's see how they do escorting bombers. Last time they did a bomber escort mission, they actually downed a bomber while they were out. I was just like, eh? They must have crossed paths with one and engaged. Alright, looks like they did okay. Austin knocked out one heavy plane, just so same kind of thing. He took out a bomber. And Paul also did, so yeah, I don't know what that's all about. Good on them. All right, and that concludes a day. We may wrap it up here. I might be back, or I might not. We'll see. But I'm gonna at least pause this one for now.